Hey guys, so this video is going to focus on how to multiply polynomial functions. So before getting into the specific problem, in order to multiply functions together, in order to multiply polynomials together, we do need to be familiar with the distributive property. We do need to be familiar with the product rule, which I'm writing on the screen right now. So remember, the product rule says that when you are multiplying like bases, you do add the exponents together. So otherwise, if you're being asked to multiply polynomial functions, so the example we have on the screen here says that f of x is equal to 3x plus 4, g of x is equal to 9x squared minus 12x plus 16. So we have a binomial times a trinomial. I am going to use the process of distributing in order to do this multiplication here. There are several techniques out there, the FOIL method, the box method, the vertical method. There's a bunch of different techniques on how to multiply polynomials together. One of the first that most people do learn is the distributive property, and that's what I'm going to use here. So the distributive property pretty much says, so if I'm taking this binomial, multiplying it times this trinomial, what I'm going to do is I'm going to do the distributive property twice with each term that I have in this first polynomial. So what that means is I'm going to take this 3x and I'm going to multiply it to everything in the second polynomial. And then I'm going to turn around and I'm going to take the 4 and multiply it to everything in the second polynomial as well. And then I'm going to combine like terms and clean it up in the end. But that's essentially how you multiply polynomials together. So starting with 3x, 3x times 9x, so 3 times 9 gives us 27. And x times x squared, remember that's the product rule over here. You keep the base, add the exponents, 1 plus 2 gives us 3. So 27x cubed. Next multiplication, 3x times the minus 12x. So 3 times negative 12 is going to give us a negative 36. And x times x gives us x squared. And our next multiplication is a 3x times the 16. So 3 times 16 gives us 48, and tack on the x with it. Now that we're done multiplying everything times the 3x, now we're going to turn around and we're going to take the 4 and we're going to distribute it to everything in the second polynomial. 4 times 9x squared, so 9 times 4 is 36. Tack on the x squared with it. 4 times a negative 12x is our next multiplication. So 4 times negative 12 gives us a negative 48. Tack on the x with it. And then our last multiplication, 4 times 16. So 4 times 16 is 64. Now we're done with the multiplication part, but now that we're done multiplying, we do need to clean up our remaining problem here by combining like terms. So combining our like terms in order from biggest to smallest, so we have it in descending order. So let's drop down the 27x cubed. That is the only cubed term that we have. Combining our x squared terms, we have negative 36x squared plus 36x squared. That is actually going to cancel out. The next thing that we have is our x to the first power terms. So we have 48x and then negative 48x. That is going to cancel out as well, which means the only thing we have left is the 64, and there is no other number for it to combine with. So that means our final answer here is 27x cubed plus 64. And that is how you multiply polynomial functions by distributing. Otherwise, that's it for this video.